Okay, of course, in-announce niya na ni presidential spokesman na papayag siya mag-travel from Marikina to Malacañang, pero sabi niya, no media coverage dapat. Okay ka ba ron?
Yeah, okay ako dun. I think that's a good suggestion that there would be no media coverage.
Bakit?
Out of respect for the other commuters.
Para hindi na kami makasikip.
Magiging spectacle siya, magiging very stressful yan for the other commuters who are already suffering. Okay. So I'm volunteering, kung pwede, di dalawa na lang kami.
You will be the observer.
Ako na lang yung siguro testigo, witness na talagang ganun. Pero it has to be from Santolan Station, mag-commute, papunta ng Cubao, tapos from Cubao, mag-LRT, papunta ng Legarda, at pagbaba sa Legarda, mag-jeep, papunta ng Malacañang.
Di ba dapat naka-disguise siya?
Hindi na natin
kasi
siya may
everybody
tatago.
Knows him, eh.
That's
everybody
really hard
knows
to do.
Him, eh.
Paano kung may bodyguards, kung may retinue
wala
siya?
Wala nang bodyguards, wala nang mga howie boys.
Ganito na lang, kuhanan mo na lang siya ng video sa phone mo, tapos exclusive mo sa amin.
Sabay na kami.
Okay. Yun,
lahat ng kasabay nun, may cellphone, sigurado.
Sigurado naman ako yung mga kababayan
lahat
natin.
Lahat ng kasama.
Kukunan niya ng lalabas naman sa social media.
Is it a crisis? This is the main question now. And it's enough to actually get the presidential spokesman to air this Panelo challenge, let's call it, to be sure he's not the first one to do this,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Well, what's your reaction to that?
It shouldn't be controversial. The statement is quite plain. We have a mass transport crisis because people are falling in line very early in the morning. There are not enough trains, there are not enough buses to get you from point A to point B. The travel time is so long, excruciatingly long. No, the quality of the transport service is very, very bad. Tumitirik, no, 3 train lines breaking down in 1 week. That's really bad. That has never happened before.
Once a week na lang down, di
once a week na lang, di ba? Pasalamat pa tayo. So it's really, really bad. It's just a statement, I think, that reflects the sentiments of a lot of commuters. So, bakit mo pa didibatihin yun eh? Yun na talaga yun eh. That's how commuters feel right now.
Well, I guess he's trying to prove now that it's not a crisis. I mean, the fact that you're able to get from point A to point B in an hour and a half, that's not a crisis yet. Now, if you're not able to get there, that's a crisis. Maybe in his estimation.
Yeah, his definition is that there's no crisis if there's no paralysis. So long as there are cars on the road, so long as there are buses and trains functioning, it's not a crisis. But has it ever occurred to him that yung travel time is really, really bad, really, really hard for a lot of people? In fairness to Secretary Panelo, he admits there is suffering among commuters. Good. Pero has it also occurred to him that the suffering is caused by the mass transport crisis? Hindi naman nangyari ang suffering na yan out of nowhere. Eh. May pinanggalingan yan. It has accumulated over 3 decades. And now, the current generation is having to face this, you know, very big problem.
And so what if it's a crisis? I guess that's the point. What is the point in labeling this a crisis?
If it's a crisis, then there's a sense of urgency. There is this need to address it head on. Wag nating i-sugarcoat. Tignan natin siya, malalang problema to. We take drastic steps. We make a long-term plan, a long-term program to once and for all end that situation.
They're asking for emergency powers already. That's a recognition that it's a crisis.
Exactly, right?
I don't even know how the emergency powers will fix the trains. They can't even explain that. Will the emergency powers fix the trains? Hindi naman eh. Diba? Do you need emergency powers to maintain trains? I don't think so.